So, are we back in business? Can you hear me again? Or can you see me again? Yeah, I think you can, yeah. All right. So, we are at level 260. We want to be Scopulos 4000 feet, which means we have to descend 22,000 feet. 22 times 3 is 66. And as well, we need to slow down a little bit, so let's add 20 miles, so 86 miles before Scopulos, we're gonna start a 3-degree descent path. At the moment, we got 137. What is my FMC thinking? What are you thinking about 67? Let's see, 1, 30, 66, that's one is only 60 miles before. So we have to descend a bit earlier. We will definitely need full flaps to land and a few more knots to cater for the headwind. 50 knots. All right. I stopped explaining. So when you have an MDA for a circle to land approach, yeah, you descend to 1700 feet, and that's what you set on your minimum, because this is what you descend to and you maintain until you leave your downwind or base to land. However, if you fly a real IFR procedure and CDFA or even non-CDFA, we are working nowadays not anymore with MDAs, we're working with DAs, which is a decision altitude. And to cater for the reaction, the second you need to react to decide, you add 50 feet to the MDA to make sure you do not undershoot this altitude. Because if you fly a precision approach, for example, an ILS, and a minimum of, let's say, 200 feet above ground, above the threshold, the decision altitude is already factoring the fact that you will probably undershoot until 150 feet or whatever before you will climb again, if you decide at the minimum to go around. Bierchen. Aber warum Bierchen? Bierchen? Nee, wir trinken doch nicht. Das machen wir ganz brave Piloten. Uso, sehr gut. Ich bin gerade in den Screenshots. Sehr gut. Coole Aktion, ja. Ah, zum Griechen könnte ich essen gehen diese Woche mal. Gute Idee. Alle im Galopp. Geht OBS wieder? Ach, du bist das, Olli. Jetzt verstehe ich, wer der User CXBin ist. Cancel the bin, oder was ist das? Okay, da bin ich zufrieden, wenn der Stream läuft. Immer wieder nett. Immer wieder nett. Cancel Bailén VOR kenne ich, ja. Da werden wir oft hingeschickt, immer in Spanien rumfliegen, so in der Sevilla gegen Sevilla, Malaga. Direct Bailén. Direct Bailén. Sí. Oh ja. Thank you for the shortcut. Aber was ist dann BLN? Erklär's doch. Keine Ahnung. Hm. Echt. Also, Cancel Berlin. Will Berlin Airport ever open? The new one. So, we had 94 DME to Skopelos, so we will start our descent soonish. Alright, 4000 feet. This will be a nice speed, vertical speed. So let's see, ground speed is 500 knots. So 50 or 500 divided by 60 is about 8. Or 50 by 6 is about 8. 8 times 6 is 48. So 8 times 3 is 24. So we need a rate of descent of 2400 plus 100 because it's more than 20. It's 20 knots more than 480. But of course the ground speed will decrease now as well, together with our true air speed. Weil wir im Sinkflug geht die true air speed runter. Ganz normal. Das ist eben auch eine Möglichkeit, wie man Ascenter separieren kann, indem man den Flieger, der mehr Abstand kriegen muss, zum nächsten früher runterschickt, wenn er auf ihn aufläuft. So, wir machen heute einen Spezialanflug in Skiathos. Die erste Runde ist, die erste Runde wird ein Low Approach. Und dann drehen wir, oder vielleicht ein Touch and Go? Mal machen Touch and Go. Wie lang ist die Bahn? 1000, ne, wir machen keinen Touch and Go, das ist zu kurz. Wir machen Low Approach. Und dann fliegen wir einmal außen rum und machen eine schöne Chandelle und landen zurück auf der 1.9 nochmal. Mal gucken, wie das klappt. Ja, same Machspeed, das klappt, aber wenn eh beide runter müssen oder wenn der eine eh absinken muss, dann kann der Free Speed fliegen und rumkachern, wie er mag. Und alle haben ja auch andere Winddaten in ihrem Simulator. Das ist halt derselbe Scheiß. Könnte mal Heading nachziehen. Gibt es hier keinen Heading Sync Button? Nein, es ist kein Airbus. Also, we're going to an altitude, QNH 1010 set. Ich mache nochmal ein Update vom Wetter. Ja. 120 degrees, 15 knots. Kavok. 22 degrees, 1010. Ah, das Wetter ist von. Das Wetter ist von 13.50 Z. Okay. Mal gucken, hat mein. FSGAW vielleicht besseres Wetter? Review Weather Station. LGSK. Ah ja, 160 mit 15, das werden wir haben. 160 mit 15, 16 Grad, 1007. Okay. Dann machen wir 1007. Lieber den niedrigen Wert eindrehen, als dann zu tief zu fliegen, aus Versehen. Autobrake 2. Ja, nee, aber die Technik, was mit dem einen früher absinken lassen, haben wir von einem echten Maastricht-Lotsen gelernt. Vor ein paar Jahren bei einem Seminar. Das fand ich auch ganz elegant gelöst. Ich glaube, ich war etwas zu forsch hier mit dem Sinkflug. Den machen wir etwas flacher. Ja, eben, aber wenn ich einfach einen früher runterschicke, dann muss ich keinem irgendeine Speed zuweisen. Das ist das Schöne dabei. So, wir genießen mal hier die Szenerie. Naja, die Wolken. Da sind ein paar schöne Inselchen. Der kann langsamer werden, das macht ja nichts, aber ich habe immer noch Separation. Vertikal halt, dann macht es ja nichts. Wenn der andere kachelt, kann er überholen. Das ist mir egal dann. Die ganze Bagage unterwegs. Eben, das Wetter von Watzim ist hängen geblieben bei 1350Z. Ich hoffe aber darauf, dass das Wetter von FSGAW, was ich nutze, reingetan wird, dann auch entsprechend das Reale ist. So, wir bescheißen heute mal, wir fliegen auch unter Level 100 Highspeed. Wir machen nur hier mal Seatbelts on, Wing Light on, Landing Lights on. Mission continues. Speed Brake armed. Oh, ich habe das schon ein paar Mal probiert und das hat eigentlich ganz gut geklappt. Lieber Watze. So, Level 100, ja, Speed 330, we know. We are naughty, naughty, naughty. So, wir haben noch keine NDB oder ADF-Anzeige. Na, auf dem 1er schon hier, auf dem, aber auf unserem kleinen hier noch nicht. Naja, mal näher kommen. So, die Insel da vor uns, das dürfte Skopelos sein und Skiat ist dann die hier. Mal schauen, sieht man da schon was? Langsam. Genau, ja, das ist Skiat. Der Flughafen, da kann man ihn sehen, hinter diesem kleinen Bergrücken da. Vor dem großen Bergrücken, hinter dem kleinen. Da ist die Landebahn, da wollen wir hin. Ihr macht heute mal einen Fliesenleger-Approach. Kacheln bis zum Aufsetzen. Den habe ich glaube ich schon mal erzählt. Der ist alt, ich weiß. Dass die Speedbrakes so tanzen, obwohl die auf Arm sind, das ist doof. Hat sich beruhigt, oder was? Ne? Hat sich beruhigt? Ja. It's calmed down, very good. Alright, then 10 miles to go, time to slow down.
1000 to go.
Alt acquire green. Ja, ich arbeite auch mit Speeds, aber es ist schön zu sehen, dass es auch mit dem Descent eigentlich ganz gut klappt. So, wir machen hier schon mal 2000 Fuß. Als Vorbereitung, wir dürfen aber erst absinken nach dem VOR und erst nur auf 3000 bei DIMI 3, ne? Haben wir gesagt. Und dann erst runter auf 2000 bei DIMI 7. Kenny, es klingt völlig widersinnig, aber es klappt eigentlich wirklich ganz gut. Aber es geht natürlich nicht mit jedem Piloten. Das musst du schon mit Leuten machen, die, von denen du glaubst, dass die da das auch drauf haben. So, we just passed the VOR, vertical speed. What's our ground speed? 250, 240 by 6 is 4, 4 times 3 is 12, 1200 feet a minute. flaps one to keep the speed under control. Skiatos traffic, Nor Shuttle 33 Kilo starting the locator runway 19 approach out of Skopilos. Flaps 5. And we continue down 1700 feet after DME 7, which is in 1 mile from now.
Thousand to go.
Checked. Awesome. Get out. Flaps 10. Flaps 15. Flaps 25. Alt acquire green. Next step is leave 1700 feet at this point. FQ19.
Approaching minimums.
Yeah, we are VMC. Okay, I was a bit early in configuring to 25. I could have probably left the flaps up a little bit longer and the speed up, but yeah, well, let's do it the conservative way to avoid flying too fast. So, runway heading 194. Bit of wind from the left. I got the puppy inside. Two miles to go for our final descent. Try the approach mode.
Minimums.
Final approach course green and alt hold green, glide path armed. Bloody spoilers. Pass green, flaps 30, reducing the speed further. Rev speed is 133 or so. Yeah, 134. Let's do final approach 140. And flaps 40. Let's have some fun. Autopilot off, auto throttle off. Okay, then joining the extended center line, we're slightly high, can see on the puppy. So don't forget, we will not land now, we will just make a low approach, we'll go around, we're gonna reverse, we're gonna fly over runway 01, clean and fast. And we're gonna make a nice maneuver to hopefully land without breaking the aircraft. Ah, we can touch maybe quickly with the main wheels and then we go around. We can do this too. Sounds like fun. Just fly low. And now altitude callouts. What's going on, my friend? Mighty aircraft. Let's not scratch those sailboats. That was too much pull. Yeah, speed check. Pitch 12 only, please. Yeah. You need quite a trim a lot. So, positive rate, gear up. Flaps 10. Flaps 5. And we level off here. Speed check. Flaps 1. I don't like flashing lights. And flaps clean. Let's make a nice 80 to 60 reversal. So course 200, right 280, and immediate left turn again. And we should end up on the axis, on the reverse course, with the runway. To 70 degrees and 280, and we turn around. Bank 30 degrees, we are a bit high, that's okay. Correcting. Still climbing, what the hell? Hi Cal. You just joined at the right time. We're doing some stupid stuff here around Skiathos. Skiathos traffic, Nor shuttle, 3-3 kilos doing some stupid stuff. We're doing runway 01, low pass, pull up, turn around, come back for runway 19. Actually, low pass 01, then reversal for only 19. Yeah, I'm a real pilot, but when I play simulators as well, I do stupid things that I can't do in the real one. Life is supposed to be fun. So, and you see, it worked exactly. Yeah? We are back on the axis of the runway. 80 degrees right, and then immediately left turn 260, because 80 and 260 is 360. It's a full. Alright, let's get some speed and the nose down to have some fun. I hope the plane will not stall or have overstress or whatever.
Approaching
Explain,
minimums.
Simulates.
Minimums.
Yeah, continue. Oh, go on. Don't go too fast, my dear. No, don't worry, we're not going to crash. We just make a low pass. Yeah. We just make a low pass. And then we will pull up. I fly for a private jet company, so no airline. So now we fly 20 seconds out over the sea. No, I don't fly the 737 for real now.
Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain. Too low terrain.
So, pop. Let's see what the plane will
Bank
do.
Angle. Yeah. Bank angle.
Speed is checked. Flaps 5. Gear down. Now we push on the stick to reduce our angle of attack. Too much. Poor flaps. Poor flaps. But we will control the thing, don't worry. Flaps 15. Bit of thrust to spool up the engines so they are more responsive. Oh, we are way too far away. Off. Okay. We're supposed to do that much closer to the airfield and not so far away. It's boring. We will do that again with a nice aircraft, like the Beech 58 or the King Air. Then you can do it really close by. You pull up, you go to 80 degrees, 70 degrees pitch, and you bleed off the speed, left rudder, pull the nose down, or push the nose down, and then you make a nice chandelle. Alright, so, gear down, three greens, flaps full, green light, air brake 2, speed brake armed, let's land the plane. I'm flying on a VATSIM, but at the moment there's nobody controlling the area, so. I'm flying on Unicom, otherwise I couldn't do this kind of stuff. So puppy, 3 red, 1 white, approaching the 2 right, 2 red, so we can continue our descent. Oh, too high. Oh la la. Ah, dear plane, what are you doing? Idle, and this little bump on the runway, it's a bit mean. Full reverse, auto brake works. Yeah, in the real world I would get fired if I did this, yeah. So now we have to carry on to the turn pad. Yeah, 293, that's better than the butter landing in München. Hey Claudio. I'm tempted to do the reversal again. You know what? We try it again. What are you complaining about, my dear aircraft? The trim is fine. 80 knots. Oof! What the hell is going on? Sorry, guys. My plane didn't do as expected.
Whoa!
Okay, I crashed it. Oh, stop, 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 not into the sea. I'm on the brakes, but this plane is refusing to slow. No, 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 no. Anchor deployed. Very funny. Oh dear. Okay, we are swimming. Swimming in the rain. Do you remember this video from this private jet in Toronto at the city airport? That overshot the runway and went into the sea, into the lake? Yeah, an awesome swimmer. I'm trying to steer now with differential power. I only have thrust on the right engine. Oh, that was too much. All right, let's end this experiment. Okay. LGSK runway 20, yeah. You didn't see anything, did you? But let's have a look for this bloody video that I wanted to show you. Toronto Airport Citation Landing Water. Where is it? It's not this one. Oh, maybe I should as well write it. Toronto City Airport Water Landing. Maybe this one. Come on, where's the video? Maybe London City, Toronto, private jet crash. Maybe this. No, 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 no.
Guys, the Leo's on board.
No, No. How can you become a pilot? Yeah. Not do this stuff on the internet. Oh, come on, where is this bloody video? Toronto Island Airport citation landing water. It was really popular, this video. It was like 10 years ago, it must have been. And actually the owner of the plane then got a new one, and he got this plane registered as Whiskey Echo Tango Wet, so he has some humor. No, I can't find it now. Oh, we're back on course. Yeah, very funny. I will find this bloody video. I'm really motivated now. Toronto City, yeah. Is it this one? Or Toronto Island? That's the same, huh? No, I can't find it. Okay, well then, tough luck. Yeah, it's too long ago, and it's like 10 years ago I last watched this video. Basically, somebody videoed the plane floating in the water after landing, after the guy overshot the runway, and then he evacuated, but due to some short circuit, one engine starts up by itself again, and at you as well pushes up the throttle a little bit, and then the plane keeps floating in the water with one engine running and doing circles and circles and circles until at some point the engine just dies. It's quite funny actually. So we are back in course, but I will not fly anymore, guys. It's midnight here. That's enough for today. But now I really want to find this bloody video. Where is it? Oh, I think I found it. Yep. That's really bad quality of video. We got a nut ball.
Trying to land. Everybody's...
Yeah, it was almost 15 years ago.
I think everybody's
this is the guy,
okay.
The pilot,
they should
yeah.
be all
Danish
right.
guy. Fat pilot. So they evacuated. And then suddenly the engine starts up again.
They're cutting the rope.
That freaking engine's still running, I don't believe it. Holy shit.
Tim, yeah, this is the famous Gaia-SEM add-on scenery. It is,
oh,
yeah.
Shit,
indeed. It's very good, I recommend it.
He's trying to get away from it. It's powering up.
Last jet, that's all I see on it.
Get away, get away.
Any idea what they were doing landing a beta?
Doesn't matter, Mark, it ain't
okay. They're getting away.
So you see the engine starts up
oh boy.
Itself, and there we go, full thrust.
Is there somebody in there doing that?
The jet is now powering forward.
Yes, there was some due to the water and the computers or whatever. And the,
it doesn't look good.
There was some malfunction which caused a short circuit or whatever. That caused the engine to start up and spool up by itself. No, there was nobody anymore in the cockpit. All had evacuated. They were only in these boats. There was the pilot and some passengers. That did. Course function. You mean?
Seems like the plane is still moving forward.